Hello, and welcome to our Blueprint MedTech Program Overview. I'm Jessica Tillman, one of the project managers for MedTech, and today I'll be providing an overview of the program, including program structure and the application process. The Blueprint MedTech Program is an NIH incubator that aims to support innovators by accelerating the development of cutting-edge medical devices to diagnose and treat disorders of the nervous system. Our mission is to catalyze the translation of novel neurotechnologies from early stage development to first in human clinical studies. Our goal is to accelerate patient access to groundbreaking, safe, effective medical devices. We do this by providing support to sufficiently develop and de-risk technologies to the point where additional investments are warranted from industry partners, investors, and government. Significant costs are associated with phase 2 and 3 clinical trials and the marketing required to move a device forward. And so we try to reach that value inflection point to attract investors that will take it further. The program combines the strengths of research and industry together. Investigators and their ideas for novel devices are combined with industry expertise through a network of subject matter expert consultants and contract services through our CROs. 14 institutes and centers participate in the Blueprint MedTech program. However, not all participating ICs are signed on to each announcement. All projects must fall under the mission of one of the ICs signed on to an open announcement. Participating ICs and their points of contact are shown here, with core POCs shown in bold. For specific IC requirements and interest statements, please visit our website's participating IC page, shown below. The Blueprint MedTech program provides both funding and resources. Funding is provided through NIH grants or other mechanisms, depending on the stage of the device. The program also provides access to NIH-funded consultants, CROs, and NIH staff. Here, I would like to take some time to go through the structure of the program. The Blueprint MedTech program consists of two phases, development and translation. Relatively early-stage groundbreaking neurotechnologies that have at least shown proof of concept enter the program in the development phase. Further developed devices that are ready for early feasibility testing will enter the translation phase. As you can see, different funding sources are used to support projects in the development phase versus the translation phase. Incubator Hubs, awarded through the MedTech Incubator Hub funding mechanism, will provide funding and guidance for development phase sub-projects. The hubs are also expected to provide some resources to all MedTech projects, regardless of phase. All MedTech projects are provided access to a variety of resources. These resources are provided at no extra cost to investigators to support device development and optimization. Resources are provided by the incubator hubs and NIH-funded CROs. These include services for design prototyping and bench testing, business development, biocompatibility and animal studies, regulatory compliance and quality, and clinical support. Assistance and advice from consultants and industry experts will also be provided. Before we discuss the research projects funded by MedTech, I would like to briefly discuss our program's use of incubator hubs. As I mentioned in earlier slides, some of the Blueprint funding opportunities and resources will be provided through hubs, highlighted here in orange. Incubator hubs are centers funded through the Blueprint MedTech incubator mechanism to coordinate and manage resources for the Blueprint MedTech program, as well as provide MedTech-funded innovators with many of the resources needed to support development of their devices into human-grade prototypes. The hubs are also expected to provide some resources to all Blueprint MedTech projects, regardless of phase. While the awarded centers will provide many of the resources needed to prepare for first-in-human testing, other resources will be provided by other awardees in the Blueprint Consortium. For more information about the hubs and how to apply to the Incubator Hub funding opportunity, please visit our website and view our Incubator Hub funding opportunity video. In the next couple of slides, I will briefly touch on the other projects MedTech supports. To learn more about these funding opportunities, please view the Translator Mechanism video on our website. To enter the program, projects need to provide proof of concept data of device function. Devices can enter nearly anywhere along the spectrum. However, projects for which only a clinical phase is proposed are outside the scope of our funding opportunities. We aim for projects to exit to external funding partnerships or another grant for a larger clinical trial. However, if a project doesn't meet its milestones, there is attrition in the program. Applicants to our program must include novel medical device technologies that will advance upon current neurotechnology. The devices are expected to be first-of-its-kind technologies with unique and novel intended uses or address new safety or regulatory questions. Devices may also pivot and refine existing technologies toward new intended use or use in novel settings. We expect that most devices will follow the FDA, De Novo, or PMA regulatory pathways. However, those that meet an existing 510K pathway may also be acceptable if they meet these specific conditions. But again, we expect that most will fall under the novel De Novo category, as the MedTech program is designed to support the transition of groundbreaking technologies for which other mechanisms of support likely do not exist. We are currently accepting applications for three funding opportunities. Part 21314, Blueprint MedTech Incubator Hub, was created to solicit centers or incubator hubs to coordinate and manage program resources. Part 21315 and 282 provide funding for translational activities and clinical studies to advance the development of therapeutic and diagnostic devices for disorders that affect the nervous or neuromuscular systems. Early stage device development projects will be solicited and funded by the incubator hubs. While we will touch on the projects funded by these opportunities during the presentation, I encourage you to visit our website for videos on the opportunities and how to apply. Early stage projects will be funded through the incubator hubs. In addition to seedling funding, these projects will receive mentoring and design support to address any issues surrounding the project that may hinder late-stage development or translation of the device. Late-stage projects will also be funded through the incubator hubs. The purpose of these projects are to develop clinical-grade commercial prototypes that are as close to the final system as possible and to manufacture the prototypes using processes very close to the intended product to be marketed. More information on the early and late stage funding opportunities will be provided by the incubator hubs at a later date. The translator funding opportunities are organized as two-phase funding mechanisms. However, all projects must enter in the first non-clinical testing phase, known as UG3 or U44 phase 1 for the small business opportunity. Up to 4 years of funding are available for this initial phase. The purpose of this phase is to identify and conduct all non-clinical testing necessary to obtain approval to conduct the clinical study, or in other words, complete testing to support an IDE submission or to obtain IRB approval for a non-significant risk clinical study. Design execution plans and go/no-go milestones for the second phase are also required. Once administrative approval is obtained, translator projects will enter the second phase of the mechanism, known as UH3 or U44 phase 2 for projects funded by the small business opportunity. This phase can be supported by up to 4 years of funding. The purpose of this phase is to support clinical studies that provide information about the device or final design that cannot be practically obtained through additional non-clinical assessments. Through this phase, we will support clinical studies that will likely lead to a marketing application, a larger clinical study that will lead to a marketing application, or use of the clinical experience to inform device design decisions. Please note that although each stage can be funded up to 4 years, the total project period, including both phases, must not exceed 5 years. For example, if the first phase is 3 years, the second phase cannot exceed 2 years. Another point I would like to emphasize is that we try to preserve the investigator's intellectual property. Before the grants are awarded, the investigator's institution are expected to have IP agreements in place with all potential inventors. IP agreements should aim for unencumbered IP, consistent with the Blueprint program's goal to support licensable products. So this is our website. We have a lot of useful information on there, and I would encourage you to visit. There you'll find information about how to contact our staff and participating IC contacts, the resources and support services we offer, and our funding opportunities. Well, I would like to finish by telling you about some do's and don'ts for applying to the funding opportunities. First, please read the funding opportunity announcement carefully. There are specific requirements that are different in each one, so please read carefully and be sure not to include information that shouldn't be there. Do discuss the proposal with MedTech IC POCs. This will allow you to gauge whether their IC's level of interest might be, whether it's a fit with their mission, and if they would be supportive of the project was potentially funded. If you're applying to the U44 and you have any SBIR specific questions, please contact the SBIR program directors. Make sure to stick to any page limits listed. You also want to make sure that you put forth your solid scientific preliminary data and address the rigor of the data in your research strategy section. Please remember to address it both in your own studies that you plan to do and the ones you've already performed, as well as any cited preliminary data. You also want to be sure to address any obvious criticisms. Another point I really want to emphasize is to clearly indicate what's going to be done by your lab versus what you expect to be done by the Blueprint MedTech resource providers. The research funding opportunities do require that you complete a resource checklist, so please clearly state that you will complete task ABC and you expect Blueprint MedTech contracts to, or contractors to perform XYZ. And also make sure to include budget sheets for all years of your grant. Some additional things to do, if you're applying to the UG3 UH3 program and you're going to exceed $500,000 in direct costs in any year of the project, you will need permission to submit the application. These requests should be made 6 to 8 weeks prior to the submission date. And lastly, do talk to your tech transfer and business development groups as early as possible because they need a plan for funding of patents and licensing activities. And they also have to be on board with setting up the IP agreements. Additionally, if IP agreements between you and your co-investigators or other institutes are necessary, those will need to be in place by the time we're ready to award these grants. So a couple things not to do. Please don't plan on this being a sole funding source for your lab. This is milestone driven and can end abruptly. And secondly, do not under-resource your budget to avoid the budget limits. If you need to come in and ask for more than $500,000 in direct costs and you have a good justification for it, please talk to us about it and we can discuss that. Again, Blueprint MedTech is now accepting applications. Please read the funding opportunities carefully. We have PAR 21314 for centers interested in participating as an incubator hub, and two research funding opportunities, PAR 21315 for all applicants, and PAR 21282 for small businesses. Please note that small businesses are eligible to apply to PAR 21315 as well. And I'll end with some pictures of our core team. This concludes our presentation, and if you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at blueprint-medtech@nih.gov. Thank you.